In this segment, we're going to talk about the formula for a quadratic equation. So let's go and see what a typical quadratic equation looks like. So generally, it looks like this ax squared plus bx plus c equal to 0. And the formula for finding the solution for it, for a not equal to 0, is as follows, that x is equal to minus b plus minus square root of b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a. It basically means that there are two roots, one root being minus b plus square root of b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a, and the other root is minus b minus square root of b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a. So those are the two roots of a typical quadratic equation. And once you find out what these values are, you'll be able to find out what the two roots of the equation are. Thing to note is that this is called the discriminant. So square root of b squared minus 4ac is called the discriminant. And based on whether what the value of this b squared minus 4ac is, your roots can take certain forms. So what does that mean? That means as follows, that if your b squared minus 4ac is greater than 0, the roots are real. The reason why the roots are real is because b squared minus 4ac is greater than 0. When you take the square root of b squared minus 4ac, you'll get a positive number and a negative number. So it doesn't matter, you take the positive root of it because you have plus minus in front of that. So b squared minus 4ac, if it's greater than 0, then the roots are real. If b squared minus 4ac is equal to 0, then the roots are identical. And the reason why the roots are identical is because when b squared minus 4ac is equal to 0, you don't have the plus minus part of it. So the roots will be identical for that case. Now, if b squared minus 4ac is less than 0, then the roots are complex. And the reason why the roots are complex is because if b squared minus 4ac, the square root of b squared minus 4ac will be an imaginary number. Hence, you will get complex roots for that. So let me again explain. If you look at x is equal to the roots of the typical quadratic equation look like this, b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a. So if b squared minus 4ac is a positive number, then the square root of that is taken as the positive number. You can take it as the negative number. That's not going to affect anything so far as the roots are concerned, because you have a plus or a minus here. So if b squared minus 4ac is greater than 0, you take the positive square root of that, and then you can see that you are going to get real roots and distinct roots of the quadratic equation. If b squared minus 4ac is equal to 0, then this quantity here is 0. So you have minus b divided by 2a as one root and minus b by 2a as the other root. So the roots are identical, or what people might call as the roots are repeated. B squared minus 4ac is less than 0, then you can see that this quantity here becomes a negative quantity. So the square root of a negative quantity will be an imaginary number. So you will get complex roots of this particular quadratic equation. There will be complex conjugates of each other, because you will have plus the imaginary number and negative of the imaginary number in your roots itself. And that's the end of this segment.